really love it. Aussies, we love our lamb, but we tend to save it for special occasions like Easter, Christmas, and maybe Sunday roasts, right? However, it can become a more regular addition to your weekly dinner menu. Here to show us how is former MasterChef contestant Hayden Quinn.
Hey! Hello, ladies. How are you?
Wonderful, thank you. Got a bit of lamb going, but first of all, can you tell us about the different cuts of lamb?
Oh my gosh, we've got so many different options here today. The one we're cooking today is a four-quarter chop.
Okay.
But we're using an Indian spice.
Okay.
And with that one simple spice rub, you can use it on so many different cuts. We've got a lamb shoulder here, perfect for slow cooking. Add that flavour to that. We've also got lamb shanks. You could use that as a base to a long, slow-cooked lamb shank.
Mm-hmm.
We've also got a lamb mini rump. A rolled loin, lamb leg steaks, all really quick cuts. So that's perfect for Wednesday night, you're at home, you just want to get it done.
Yep.
Really quick, in and out, like this dish today. So what we should do, I think we should marinate our four-quarter chops.
Okay.
So really, I'll get my hands dirty on here.
Sure.
Then I'll ask you to help me with some of the marinade.
So these have been marinated?
They've been correct? Marinated, and they're the ones I've left you in charge of. So if you wouldn't mind keep cooking those,
okay,
that'd be perfect.
Now, obviously, you put that in a hot pan.
A nice hot pan. We want to get a bit of colour on the outside.
Yep.
Get a little bit of a crispy coating, and that's what this marinade's going to do.
Yes.
So, Sarah, would you mind doing some of these?
So, what's in the marinade?
Okay, so that's a little bit of chilli jam.
Ooh.
I've stick it straight on?
Just put it here, then we'll mix it in that corner.
Okay.
I've also got some grated ginger.
Mm. Ooh, how good's ginger?
Yeah, it's perfect. I'm going to throw that in there.
So fresh.
Also, if you wouldn't mind pouring in that garam masala, that would be amazing.
Now what is
that's
that?
The spice.
So garam masala is like a traditional Indian spice mix.
Right.
So it's got a whole heap of other different spices in there that come together to give that beautiful flavour.
Can you buy it from supermarket?
Supermarket, anywhere. Bam. All these dishes are super accessible. They're really easy to do. You know, if we can do them here standing in front of the TV camera, I'm sure you can do them in the kitchen at home.
Great.
So we've got some poppy seeds, a little bit different.
Poppy seeds?
Yeah, it gives it a bit of crunch, a little bit of flavour. Obviously, any sort of protein, especially our lamb, loves a little bit of salt.
Yeah.
So that's going to go in as well. Thank you, thank you. And we've got some cinnamon too. Now, we want to be sparing with the cinnamon. Don't want to go too heavy-handed, but again, it adds a beautiful flavour. You know, normally you think of cinnamon for like sweets or muffins or something like that, but it works absolutely beautiful with this dish.
Is that mixed enough?
That looks good. I'm going to loosen it up with some olive oil. So if you wouldn't mind mixing
that. Now, in
that.
Terms of health, how does lamb compare to other meats? Is it good to be eating a couple of, like healthy to be eating a couple of times a week?
Yeah, definitely. You know, it's a beautiful lean protein. It's all got to do with the choice of cut that you pick and you want to cook. Obviously, if there's any excess fat, you can remove that yourself before you start the cooking process.
That's the best part.
But you look at that lamb leg steak or the mini roast, there's not one little bit of fat on there. And perfect for midweek, really simple stuff. Okay, I'm going to get my hands dirty. What do you think?
Do it.
Is that me?
Yep.
Okay.
That's got to be all the hands, of course.
Sorry?
Right in with the hands.
Yeah, right in with the hands. Yeah, you got to get in there with your hands. Marinate that nicely. Get it well coated. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you could do this in the morning and leave it during the day for work and then come home and throw them on the barbecue, chuck them in the pan, whatever
easy,
it may be.
It?
Or like we're doing now, just simply marinate it for, you know, 10, 15 minutes, half an hour, whatever time you've got. It's got such a beautiful amount of flavour. So that's pretty simple. We're going to leave that, let it come to room temperature, and that's when we go into the pan, okay?
And
I'm going to find my
almost
little...
ready up
there it is.
Here's a question. I know you've put olive oil in the marinade. Does that mean you have to then put more oil in the pan, or is that enough?
No, I normally, with the marinade like this, because there is a lot of olive oil in it, I just put it in a dry pan.
Oh, great.
Nice hot heat, get that colour on it.
Yep.
Then just turn it down
just a little bit, and then flip it, and sort of keep turning it. It's really, really nice.
Okay.
Oh.
So, and you're going to have it pink.
Yeah, it's got, the lamb likes to be nice and medium rare in the centre, so a little bit pink, which is perfect.
Now, what would you serve this Indian-inspired lamb with?
Oh, I think you know. There we go.
So something like this, maybe?
Something like that, exactly right. Very well
done.
What
have we got here? You've got zucchinis?
So, yeah, these are some zucchinis which we basically just quartered. Really, really simple. And I reserved some of the marinade, and I've just brushed the marinade over the zucchini in the same pan, on the same barbecue, whatever it may be.
Before or after the lamb?
You do it after, so while the lamb's
resting.
You've got
the lamb kind of taste. While
the lamb's resting, do your zucchinis, chuck them on the plate, and in a really simple salad, which I know you can help me with. If you wouldn't mind just getting a little bit of tomato. There, look at that still. Amazing. That's how I do it at home. That's beautiful.
I've been watching Nigella Week on MasterChef.
I wonder that. That's all that's
time to plate it up and have a taste.
When you take the lamb off, it's good to let it sit.
Yeah, it's very important.
That's what's important.
So don't put them straight on the plate.
No, with our beef and lamb, you want to take it off, put it on a another dish, cover it with foil, keep it warm, and just let those juices, I guess, reabsorb back into the meat.
Yeah.
Let it relax. You know when you get sunburnt and your skin's really tight? It's the same in the pan. The protein gets really tight and then you need it to relax and then all the juices distribute beautifully.
How fantastic. Can we give it a taste? We don't have any knives and forks, so we're just going to have to eat it like cavemen. And
Here you go. Do you want to put that one on this one? I think there's a bit of room there. Oh, that looks lovely.
And forks we do need.
We did forget
we
the
knives
and forks. Here we go.
All right.
There you go.
Thank you.
Do we have enough room here?
Let's have a check. Let's check out what it's like inside.
Oh, look at that.
That is perfect colour,
is
isn't
perfect.
It? Try that out.
That's all you.
You see that?
Very well done.
Good job, Paula.
Yeah. I do a lot of cooking.
Would you like to try some, Paula?
Yeah, I'd love to taste
You'll taste it. I'm going to say thank you, Hayden. Thank you, Hayden. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
And Hayden has just released a new book. It is called Surfing the Menu. It's filled with 80 amazing recipes inspired by local Aussie growers and food producers. You can pick one up at all good bookstores and online. How is it?
Yum.
Yeah, pretty good.
Isn't it?
Absolutely gorgeous.
The marinade, really simple, really easy and very tasty.
Easy. We'll put all the details on our Facebook page.
I'll be going for that tonight. I'll give that a go, I tell you.